21-month old male came to us with complaints of recurrent vomitings for last 1 year, which was 7 to 8 per day, non-bilious, non-projectile, containing ingested food matter only, sometimes within few minutes of eating. There was no history of dysphagia, drooling of saliva, or weight loss. There was past history of PPI and antiemetics, which were prescribed to the child for this reason. And there was only partial improvement, but child was still vomiting. So the child was investigated on OPD basis and all his blood tests were within normal limits. So a pediatrician outside did a gastrographin study for the child, though the quality is not good, but I wanted to show this picture. So the gastrographin study showed that there was holdup of contrast in the esophagus. This is esophagus, this is stomach. So what they saw that even after a few minutes, there was holdup of contrast in the esophagus with slightly constricted GE junction. So a possibility of achalasia cardia was kept in this child and the child was advised a surgery. But the patient was brought to us before the surgery in the hospital and our surgeon decided to reconfirm the diagnosis before doing that. We did an upper GI endoscopy and on endoscopy, we found that the lower end of the esophagus was not that dilated and even the GE junction was quite lax and it was easily negotiable. So we did an esophageal manometry on this child and this is what we saw on esophageal manometry. This is upper esophageal sphincter, this is lower esophageal sphincter and this is a peristaltic wave. And we can see that lower esophageal sphincter is relaxing. So this study actually ruled out achalasia cardia on this child. So just to understand how esophageal manometry is interpreted, this is how a catheter is placed throughout the esophagus into the stomach. This is lower esophageal sphincter. This is upper esophageal sphincter. In a normal study, this upper esophageal sphincter looks like a band. This is the lower junction, which again looks like a band. And whenever patient swallows, a normal peristaltic wave would look something like this, which travels with the time. And at the same time, there is relaxation. We can see that there is color coding of the graph. Anything which is towards bluer side denotes a lesser pressure, while anything which is dark and towards up denotes red or blue or violet. This all denotes a higher pressure zones. So this is a normal peristaltic wave. If it was achalasia, the typical manometric findings, what we find are increased LES pressure, as we can see, the lower esophageal sphincter never relaxed. There was complete or abnormal relaxation of lower esophageal relaxation. There is no esophageal peristalsis. This is very important. We can see after swallow, there is no peristaltic wave which is visible. And there is elevated intraesophageal pressure because of the whatever the child has ingested that stays in the esophagus. So we can see the pressure rise, but as such, no peristaltic activity is visible. So this is what is suggestive of achalasia cardia. So the message is esophageal manometry is the gold standard to rule out achalasia cardia or other motility disorders of esophagus. And only on the basis of barium swallow, we should never decide that this child has esophageal achalasia cardia and should not proceed straight away with surgery with such reports. Thank you.